Hello, friends on Facebook. Welcome to the show. My name is Dan. This is the beautiful Sellersville Theater behind me, and this is Soundbooth Sessions, our weekly live stream show where we feature a concert and a conversation with an artist we love. Of course, you know why you clicked the link. We are here this evening to hear some tremendous music. There's my first tremendous for the evening. Apparently, I say it a lot. I'm going to try to cut back. To hear some amazing music tonight by the Groove Merchants from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Here they are. They're live on our stage. They recently released an album called The Throne. That's great. And they're working on releasing a new live album. And I believe most of the songs we're hearing this evening will be on it. So when you love this show, you'll get to hear it again on their upcoming album. Ladies and gentlemen, please choose the emoji that best fits your mood at the moment, and click ferociously to welcome, all the way from the Sellersville Theater stage, the Groove Merchants.
Yes, thank you so much. Hello, everybody out there in live stream land.
A lot of happy people. Yes. A lot of happy people.
And hello to our friends in here, too. How y'all doing out here?
Great
right
now.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, this is a happy comment section, folks.
Oh, that's the beginning of the song.
I'll tell you about it after this song.
Tell me if this is real. Have you heard what's going down? Look at what Tommy's kid is doing now. Sleep all day, I don't know, just to try to do it. Making moves and running game, just so that they rubber my mind. Bobbing, styling, I'm so playing the groove. And there's some words with people I'm crying. Just to get a taste of it, man. There is nothing left to fear. It's time for me to get it clear, yeah. Turn it up and play it loud. Let them know what it's all about. I'm on the road, I'm on the trail, yeah. I'm rolling now and I cannot fail. Steaming, I'm achieving all the provisions that my mother's receiving. Just, you can tell. Come to lay it down. Hey, don't you know I've been around, babe? Oh, my soul ain't been so simple. So come on in and take a rest. Give me that taste, babe.
Goodness, guys, that sounds great. Thank you so much, Groove Merchants. You guys sound great. This is a very happy comment section. Let me tell you a little something about it. Let's see here. Way back in that first song, somebody said, horns, swoon. Loving the horns section. Jane Wells loves this. Jane, where are you tonight? Tell us where you are. Victoria Capozzoli, great night, great band. She also says, wonderful, with more thumbs than one person should have, should be able to put up. Let's see. Yvonne Vallone says, that's our son singing up there.
Yeah.
Andy Dinsmore feels that that was a great groove. And that could, of course, apply to any of the songs this evening because these are the Groove Merchants. So, speaking of the Groove Merchants, how are you guys doing? How are you, Ty? That's Ty singing lead vocals. Ty, do you want to introduce the band?
Absolutely. We are doing great. Thank you for having us, Dan. Thank you to all you wonderful people out there in live stream land. Thank you to our friends who are here in person, a select few. And we are so happy to be here. We are the Groove Merchants from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. As Dan said, my name is Ty Vallone on the vocals. Thank you guys very much. And since they're swooning over them, I'll tell you about our horn section right here. This is the Eminem horns. They're a little bit crunchy and a little bit sweet. That's Mike Talento on the tenor saxophone.
Oh, I like that.
And that's Mikey Bones really on the trombone. Give it to him one time.
Are they a little bit nuts, too?
Well, we'll find out later tonight. Back there on the bass, that's my very good friend, John Evan Groom III.
Hello, John. Sounding good, man. Laying it down.
We got young Pete Snyder on the drums right here. And with us for the first time tonight, that's Scott Coulter on the organ and the keys.
Scott.
Yes.
Wow, the newbie.
Yes.
Breaking him in.
And of course, we got cool hand Luke Faircone on the Gibson 339 all night long right over there.
Hello, Luke. Welcome back. Wait, stay on Luke for a second, Jeremy. Also, that's Jeremy on the camera. Luke, you may recognize, he was here also with the Hambone Relay. So this is a return performance from Luke.
Yes.
Welcome back, Luke.
That's right. Yeah, it's good to be back.
So Ty, give me a sense of how you guys found each other. Where did the idea for this group come from?
Well, I was sitting under an apple tree one day, and the clouds parted. No, I'm just kidding.
And an apple fell on your head.
No, myself, Luke, John Evan, we all went to Kutztown. Shouts out to any Kutztown homies that are on the live stream right now. We got one on the camera right here with the shirt, with the sweatshirt on.
That's right.
But we all went to Kutztown, and so we just found each other through various, you know, jamming on the quad or, you know, seeing people around, and we kind of put it together. And
is there a music program at Kutztown?
There's a very fantastic music program that Peter Snyder on the drums is an alumnus of.
All right.
So we kind of found each other just through, you know, all that stuff at college and kind of put a band together. And John, Evan, and Luke were actually in a group with another drummer, and I was in another group with John Evan and that same drummer. And then they were like, we were going to do a show and it was going to be the both bands. We were like, well, this doesn't make sense. Let's just be a band together. And that's kind of like how it happened. And then about 2 years ago or so, we welcomed in young Peter on the drums here, who is also a Kutztown alum. And that's kind of like the core group. And then
do you have to have gone to Kutztown to be a Groove Merchant?
You would think, but the horns up here have not gone to Kutztown. Neither has Scott, I don't think, right? Yeah. So we met them through the Philly scene, and gotcha. So whenever we get a chance to take the full seven-piece band out, we bring them along and have some fun. But our origins are definitely rooted in Kutztown, Pennsylvania, for sure.
And so tell me, when you started off the group, what was the idea, the concept for the sound? Is this what the original idea had been?
I think on some level, this was like the, one day, that'd be really cool. but we didn't know if that would ever be a reality. So the original concept was just like, let's learn enough tunes so we can like play at a couple parties.
Yeah.
And then, you know, as we progressed, it was like, oh, it'd be real cool if we could like have a keyboard player one day. And it'd be real cool if we could have horns too. And then thankfully we were able to do all those things. So this what you're seeing right now was not the initial onset, but this was always kind of like overworking towards having this sound. And thankfully we have been able to, and it's been awesome.
So, okay. So now who were you listening to at the time that was, you know, that's what kind of led you in this direction? What?
We're all like the kind of quartet here, like me, John, Luke, and Peter. We're all big like Zeppelin fans, so there's always that element. Yeah, you know it.
Sure.
And I think like the Allman Brothers, Derek Chuck's band. So just those big like Southern rock kind of deals where you see like the two drummers and the horns and stuff. But everybody also has, you know, different influences as well. So if anybody wants to share some of those, sure. I think that's what's really cool is we're always kind of pulling from each other.
Are we doing any Blood, Sweat, and Tears or Tower of Power? I mean, where the horn, this big horn, funky horn sound coming from?
Yeah, maybe not tonight, but hopefully in the near future. You can't say Tower of Power too much again, or Peter will start salivating up here.
Oh yeah, well me too. It's got the horns have me salivating already. All right, well let's do. You want to do some more tunes?
Yeah, definitely. So those first two tunes we did are from our record, The Throne, which came out in March. And I'm sure we'll talk more about that in a little bit. And this tune is also from that record. It's called Midnight Mountain Queen. And I send it out through the ether to my lovely girlfriend. It's actually our six-year anniversary today.
Whoa. Well, so congratulations.
She was nice enough to let me come and do the gig and make sure my shoes and my belt matched as well.
Oh, that's a good thing.
So this is a tune called Midnight Mountain Queen.
Midnight Mountain Queen. Let's do it.
Never climb no mountain. My ship ain't never set sail. But to get to you, babe, I'll burn out these feet, walking all the way along the Appalachian Trail. As you and me, you know we could be watching that sunrise. You're the sweetest thing I've ever seen. My midnight mountain queen. Oh, do you remember, baby, when 2 hours felt like 1,000 years? Making my way to you down Route 222 with nothing but celebration. Yeah, cause you and me, you know we're gonna be there watching that sunrise to the end of the night. You're the sweetest thing I've ever seen. make you mine forever. Let my love rain down mindlessly. Cause you and me, yeah, we can be watching that sunrise till the end of time. You're the sweetest thing I've ever seen. I'm in there, my dad,
I get a little more acoustic in the wedge up here if you can, Dan. Thank you so much. Awesome. All right, y'all.
Blow up.
Thank you so much. We'll keep it going real quick. This is another tune from our new record. And it's a song about, you know, slowing down and remembering that you don't got to do it all at once. You can just chill out because we got a lot of road ahead. And I think it means a little bit more even now because we can see over these past few months how crazy life can be. And just remember to love one another because we only got so much time to do it in. You know what I'm saying out there?
Yes, we do.
You make it last. Hell, just across on people. They all pass me time. Time passes one day. You wake up and wonder why. God. It's no fun if you're the first one done. Plenty of ways to keep the blues on the rise. On this day. For all the time we can stand. You can come on over, babe. We can take it nice and slow, yeah. And I can show you everything that you will never need to know, guys. It's no fun if we're the first ones done. Plenty of ways. and we don't regret it yet. And I will never want to be the world who doesn't let you see. All along the ways, to spend your days on this earth with me. So just take your time, and we'll all be fine. You don't have to worry, baby, baby. You're running late because love will win away. Oh, take your time.
Oh, yeah. Sounding great, guys.
Thank you guys so much. We hope you're doing good at home. Hope you're doing good in the comments section.
They sure seem to be. It's a very happy place, this comment section.
Give it up one more time for the Eminem horns on that last tune. Yes, composed and arranged by Big Mike T up here.
That was a particularly tasty horn line there, guys.
All right, well, if you thought that was tasty, we'd like to feature on this next tune my very good friend and I think co-founder of the Groove Merchants, along with myself, way, way back on the DMZ in Kutztown University. That's John Evan Groom on the four-string bass tonight. Give it to him one time. Thank you. to him one time.
Yeah.
I said, you've been stepping out on me, babe. There ain't no coming back from it this time. You know that you've been running around on me, babe. Now maybe it's the end of my life. No more talking left to do. Cause you and me are through. This is goodbye. Step on out for good. Yeah, step on out for good. Yeah, step on out for good. It's done.
Oh. Well, that was very nice, guys.
Thank you so much.
For those of you listening at home, you may not have picked up that comment. There was a live comment that said that the bass player may have burst into flames there. It was about to burst into flames. There were similar comments going on in the comment section. We have somebody said, great bass riff. Wait a minute, that was Patrick Hickey. Patrick, was that you? lots of love for the bass player. Bill Slade says, ooh, a little funky soul. Nice. We have some great emojis happening, some people expressing themselves in large-headed figures that look very happy. People loving the Eminem horns with the rock and roll horns.
Yes.
Of their hands. So this is a very happy place. Everybody is happy in the comments section. Friends in the comments section, now would be a great time to head over to our link tree to show your support for the Groove Merchants and Soundbooth Sessions if you're enjoying yourself. Thank you very much. Guys, so I'm loving the new record.
Thank you so much.
Tell me about The Throne. What were you thinking about as you were writing this record?
Who knows, man?
Who knows?
I think the whole kind of overarching thing, we had never written a record before, and I'll let Luke speak to the writing process, but just the general vibe. We'd kind of never done a record before that had kind of like an overarching theme. Everything before was kind of like, you know, just a stamp on like, these are the tunes we're you know, vibing right now.
Yeah.
But this record was kind of like, I mean, I was thinking a lot about that whole idea of, you know, kind of the grind, whether it's like, you know, a traveling musician or, you know, whatever job you're doing, you're just kind of putting in all these hours and, you know, there's a lot of times where you're driving home at 4 a.m. and you got to stop at Wawa for a cold plate of mac and cheese or whatever it is. And you're thinking, like, is this really worth it? And all those things. And the whole time you're kind of thinking, like, you know, this is all kind of one journey to finally one day be able to, like, sit on your respective throne, whatever it is, whether it's with music or in your own career, business, or finance, whatever it is, and be able to kind of look out and look over all you've done and be like, okay, I've made it now. You know, this is mine. And maybe that means, you know, stepping out of somebody's shadow or doing whatever it is. But the whole kind of vibe is like that whole journey of like, you know, everything is kind of on an upward trajectory until you finally reach the pinnacle and you're like, okay, I've done it now. And then there's, you know, some other fun nuggets kind of interspersed in there. But Luke can speak a little more to like the actual writing process.
Well, before we get to the writing process, I'm curious, where do you see yourselves on that chart? Where are you on the hill?
Not at the top. That's
not
for
at
sure.
The top yet.
Yeah.
Well, which parts of the, before we move on to songwriting, I'm just curious, like which parts of it do you find to be the grind? Which is the grind for you? I'm sure there's parts of it that are great and you love, but what are the parts that are the grind?
I mean, I think everybody probably has a different answer, but I think a lot of it is like, you know, we're not on the road now, unfortunately. No, like not really anybody is. But when you're kind of on the road and you got to cram everything into one car and, you know, find a hotel or drive to Nashville in a snowstorm,
right.
You know, and you got to do kind of all those things where, you know, you're in the car for, you know, 12 hours total and you play for 90 minutes, you know, of stage time.
Right.
And, you know, like I said, like, you know, It's a lonely time when you play till 2 a.m. and then you're driving back and whatever it is. So I think that's the kind of grinding part is like working it out, yeah, and putting the hours in. But usually it pays off when you get to come up here and do this with very, very cool people.
Very good. All right, so tell me how you wrote this record. Where do the songs typically start for you guys? Oh, Luke's coming. Here we go.
Ty and I are basically the principal songwriters. Ty writes all the lyrics, and he's very good with words, as you can tell. But this was the first record that we kind of had a more intentional approach to the songwriting. Before, it was like all the songwriting literally took place on gigs. I mean, we would...
Is that right?
More or less. I mean, we had... Yeah, we would
just kind of jam till you found something, and then...
Yeah, sometimes we'd stumble into things, and we'd be like, that was cool, let's do that every time now. And then, right. You know, that kind of thing. But this was the first time that we had rehearsal. And rehearsals used to be just gigs all the time, too. Mm-hmm. But this one, we got together and wrote tunes and recorded them and then rearranged them. Actually, Mike had a couple big contributions to arrangements.
Okay.
On tunes, which is a huge help. So kind of looking at things from that way
was
new to us. And I think it paid off in a lot of respects. It's just a different approach. I think it's... you get a different product if you do it the way we did before, which is great, but I guess it's all what you're looking for and kind of how you approach it.
What was the way before? So if this record you kind of found, you know, kind of organically, mm-hmm. What was the old process?
Literally just playing gigs and very, very loose structures that were totally on the seat of our pants. Sometimes, you know, amazing things would happen and sometimes terrible things would happen,
right.
but that's kind of just how we did. We would have, you know, one, two, or three chord tunes that Ty would write lyrics to, but it, you know, it'd be very, very different every time. Then we kind of, that was when we first started, and then we kind of honed it in and honed it in and honed it in to mm-hmm. now where we can play with other people and we don't have to, you know, keep everyone guessing. We keep them guessing a little bit.
Yeah.
So now, so I imagine, are your songs all charted so you can, you
well,
know?
I don't know, Scott. Are they charted or is it chicken scratch?
Yeah, depends what you call charted.
So we...
But you can bring people into the fold and pretty easily, you know.
Which is a very new thing for us. But
oh, that's cool.
It's helped us in a lot of ways, yeah.
And where did you record this this particular record?
So this record, well, every studio record we've done has been at the Music Center in Chester Springs with Glenn Ferracone behind the controls. So we always send love and shouts out to him. So we've done all three studio records there in like Chester Springs, Westchester area.
Okay. Oh, very good. And well, it sounds great. And I know you got another record in the works. And that's I guess that's a live record. So, is that right?
Yeah. We went to Morgan Creek Farms in Quakertown, PA. Shouts out to Adam and Steph. I'm sure they're in the comments somewhere.
Adam and Steph, where are you? Say hi.
But they were gracious enough to let us use their barn, and we recorded about four tracks. Live there, and we shot a bunch of video too.
Oh, cool.
With some of our other fellow Kutztown, some of John Evans' fellow electronic media majors from KU.
Right on.
And so we're going to be releasing a single coming up, you know, hopefully in the next couple months, next couple weeks, I should say, like hopefully around Thanksgiving, maybe a little bit later.
Super. Was there a crowd for that, or was it like a studio?
If you can call, like, you know, the people running the controls, the crowd, but
got it.
Very, very sparse and socially distant stuff.
I see.
It was just kind of like it wasn't like a live show. We went into the barn and we were like, these are the tunes, but we want to do it in kind of like a live setting rather than like be in the studio and like put the headphones on and stuff like that. Because I think where we, at least we feel like where we thrive the most, I think in a lot of times is in that live setting. And like sometimes that can come across on the album, but I don't think ever 100%. So we were like, oh, let's do something where we can see that same energy. And thankfully, we get to do it tonight for all of you wonderful people.
Excellent. Can't wait to see it. Can't wait to hear it. But we're getting a good sneak preview this evening. Guys, you mentioned The Throne there. Any chance we could hear that track?
Absolutely, yeah. So this is the title track from that record. Do you want to say something?
Oh, no. I was just going to... Yeah, we're about to play it. Still, I was saying. Yeah.
What a coincidence.
As you can see, this is all very well rehearsed stuff here.
I wonder if these dreams will ever stop. If I make my way to the mountaintop, maybe then I'll bear a different name. but our stories will remain the same. Struggle will subside, because I know in you I can't confide. Does your shadow spread across the ground, yeah? Or will my own light soon be found, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, and I try. This ground I build my home to carry with me the legend of my arm, and I'm worried that if you come on, and I'll do it all to chase the throne. To the mountaintop. Have you seen the promised land? Can I make it there without your helping hand? Oh, and I try.
Thank you so much. Keep going for Luke Faircone on the guitar right there.
Oh, Luke.
Y'all having a good time?
Yeah.
We hope you're having a good time at home.
They're doing great out there.
All right. This is a tune from our second record, which is called Take It. It's on Spotify and Bandcamp and the dark web and all that fun stuff. And I'm sure Dan's going to tell you about it in a little bit, but it's also on our brand new online store that is launched today. So we'll talk about that in a few, but this is a tune called Vigilante. Thank you so very much again. Are you having a good time still? Yeah? All right. We'll be right back. Thank you so much.
Yeah, guys.
Well, that was some mighty fine playing there, sir.
Thank you.
Nicely done, Ty. The comment section, very happy with your performance there. Andy Dinsborg comments, he hears a little Jimi Hendrix in there. Indeed.
I don't know if I go that far, but
I heard it. I don't know. I heard it. What else do we have? Michael Klippman says, righteous. Allison George says, killing it.
Tell her hello from Pennsylvania all the way down to Baton Rouge.
Oh, Baton Rouge, Louisiana. John Alderette says, the vocals are so soulful. And Victoria Capizzoli, love the horns. And John Alderette says, gotta get that on vinyl. Which is a wonderful segue. Guys, so what are your plans? What's your plan with releasing this this new record? Will it be out on vinyl?
Not yet.
That's negative.
Yeah, but we'll probably do like an electronic release at first.
Yeah.
And then maybe we'll get some physical copies down the line. But like we said, we're really stoked about the album The Throne that came out in March. Unfortunately, we didn't get the push we wanted to because of all the shenanigans and quarantine and all that stuff. But we figured we'd kind of release this live record to, you know, get the energy and get the tunes out there in another way.
Yeah.
And then hopefully people go out there and hit up both. So the new live EP is probably going to be exclusively online for now. But don't be afraid to grab that and a physical copy of all our other stuff, which you can get at our brand new online store that is up and running today.
Here we go. I got it on screen. Oh, it looks nice. As I scroll through, I see that you have three albums for sale. You got a snazzy T-shirt, some buttons or stickers, I guess. So, why didn't you have a merch page before? I guess why is it new? What?
I think it's.
Is that a sore subject? I'm sorry.
No. It's one of those things. Like, I mean, back to that idea of like the grind and the throne, or like, all right, we're selling our CDs out of our car and stuff, and that's cool. And then when, you know, the whole world shuts down, you're like, well, nobody's buying our CDs anymore because nobody's going outside. So it's just one of those things where you're like, you know, oh, we should always have one of these, but you never get around to it. And now we had, you know, 9 months to get around to stuff. So thankfully we were able to get it up and running. And we're going to have, speaking of shirts, we're going to have two new runs of shirts coming out real soon. Hopefully we'll get to be able to do some pre-orders for them. And put our store to good use. Shouts out to CJ Moyer, who does all our artwork for us. He did the artwork for The Throne and for those two brand new shirts. They're going to be coming out, so hopefully we'll get those out there real soon.
Yeah, it's good. It's good stuff.
Thank you.
So speaking of the time that's been passing, what have you guys been doing? Have you been playing shows or rehearsing together?
Over to Luke. The live EP thing. So that took a lot of organization.
That was during the quarantine.
Yeah. We did a collab video thing. We did What's Going On, right?
Oh, yeah.
Marvin Gaye tune. So that was fun. That took a lot of emailing and arguing, so that was fun. No, it was fun.
How did you stitch that together?
We sent everything to John Evan, and then he gave his critiques. And then we
I just made it work, you know?
Say that again. What did you
say?
That's
all you got?
I just, you know, come together.
Well, wait a second. Tell people, pull back the curtain. So in a quarantine, how is it that you guys were able to collaborate and make that video together without actually being in the same space?
Well, I think Ty recorded himself first, laid down acoustic guitar and vocals,
okay. And
then sent that to me, and I recorded myself playing the bass line over it.
Okay.
And then sent it over to Luke, and then I think finally Pete, about a month later, contributed to the project.
How did you bring them all together?
I work as a video editor, so doing sound mixing and stuff. So
excellent. Yeah, what do you edit in? What's your software?
Premiere, Final Cut, both of those primarily.
Okay. Yeah. Very good. I'm like just starting my video editing course here. Just doing all of this stuff, and that rabbit hole is deep.
Well, you're going to learn a lot just by doing it. So there you go.
There you go. Absolutely. All right. More music, guys? This is incredible.
You guys are doing it. You guys still having a good time out there?
Oh, yeah.
Yes. We hope you're having a good time at home. Thank you guys again for having us. Thank you to Dan and everybody for setting this up. Thank you so much for being so generous. And it feels good to get out of the house. We were bummed that we couldn't get to do this show live with Dirk Quinn in the spring. And so hopefully we can be back here again when we can see all you wonderful people in this person.
We will absolutely reschedule that show. That would have been a doozy. Tell us about this next block of tunes. What you'll be doing for us?
So this tune we're going to do right now, this is going to be the first single from that four-track live EP from the barn at Morgan Creek Farms that we're going to put out. This is a tune by Bob Dylan, if there's any Dylan fans out there.
I'm sure there's a few.
We jacked it from the Joe Cocker version that he did at Woodstock and all that stuff. But, you know, they're obviously both great. And I also think it really fits, you know, kind of our times with now with all the crazy shenanigans going on and how, you know, again, we just got to remember, you know, to love one another, because at the end of the day, that's kind of all we got out there. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So this is a tune called I Shall Be Released. And if any of you know it out there in here or in live stream land, don't be afraid to sing along or comment along, whatever you want to do. Say everything can be replaced, that every distance is not near. All right. So I remember every face of every man who put me here. I see my light come shining from the west down to the east, babe. Any day now, any way now, I shall be released. Young man stands with me in this lonely crowd, calling out that he has been framed. All day long I hear him shout and cry, calling out that he has been framed. One time, let me hear that.
anyway, now I shall be released. Well, I want to tell you about it one more time. Yeah, break it down. Any day now, anyway, now I shall be released.
That was something. We got John Aldrett was very excited to hear some Dylan. He says, monumental rendition.
Thank you very much, John.
Michael Baybuski, awesome song. Love the way Garcia played this. Indeed. Robbie Fisher's excited to hear some Dylan. Hello, Robbie. Jane Wells, kicking it.
All right. Well, thank you so very much. We're glad you're digging it. And we'll keep it going. This is a tune from our very, very first record. We've done it a bunch of different ways, a bunch of different times. And we wrote it at the apartment above the Kutztown Tavern in Kutztown, Pennsylvania. Sure, shout out once again. And we hope you dig it. This is a tune called Curtis. And that's a young Pete Snyder on the drums tonight, my people.
Better on in the road. Get right. back to where you are. Put me next to you. Plays and trains and cars. On buses, babe, I'll take any way to get me there. Yeah. And I don't care how much it costs, mama, so I gotta put on my mask and stay safe and social distant, because you know you're worth every penny of that fare. Now there ain't no you. Now, because I know you'll pull me back. So meet me at the station, babe. Because I love is coming down the train.
You got the gig. It's yours.
Thank you.
Y'all ready to go to church out there?
Said it's early in the morning, about a quarter till 3. I'm sitting here talking with my baby over cigarettes and coffee now. And to tell you that, though, I've been so satisfied. Honey, since I met you, baby, since I met you, oh, all the places that I've been around, and all the good-looking girls that I met, oh, they just don't seem to fit in. Knowing this particular setting, and it seems so natural, darling, honey, that you and I are here. Just talking over cigarettes and drinking coffee. Oh, my heart cries out, Lord, at last I found you. And won't you let me just build my whole life around? Lord, how complete my whole life would be, yeah, if you would take things under consideration and walk down this aisle with me. It is so early in the morning. Oh, it's a quarter till 3, yeah. I said I'm sitting here talking with my baby over cigarettes and drinking coffee now, now, now. And I want to tell you that, Lord, I've known nothing but good old joy. Oh, since I met you, baby, I said, baby, since I met you, won't you have another drink, baby? Oh, it's so early in the morning, baby. You know I got nothing but joy, joy, yeah. You know I had nothing but joy since I met you and took you into my life, baby. Been 6 long years and I want to go again one time. I told you I got joy, baby. Won't you smoke this one last cigarette, baby, yeah. Help me drink this coffee, baby. So early in the morning, babe. Yeah. When it seems so natural, baby, honey, then you and I believe. cigarettes and drinking coffee. Thank you so much.
Oh my goodness.
Thank you, guys. That's an Otis Redding tune, if you don't know. Yeah. Are you guys still having a good time? You still with us out there?
Yes. Yeah? Yes.
We hope you're still with us at home and in the comment section.
They sure are. A lot of love for the Keys, a lot of love for Luke. Ty, you are crushing it out there. Whoa, John Aldrett says, sketching an auditory masterpiece, a haiku of sound, one layer at a time, building to a crescendo.
He's hot. Tell him he's got the gig. He's hired.
Holy moly. Well said.
Thank you all so very much. Thank you to everybody out there watching and tuning in. We wish we could be here partying with y'all in person, but until then, we're glad to do it here, and we hope to be back again real soon. We got a couple more before we take off. Is that okay with you out there?
Oh, it's all right.
All right. This is an old blues tune by Albert King right here. Cross-cut soil, baby, drive me across your lawn. I'm a cross-cut soil, drive me across your lawn. I cut the wood so easy, baby, wanna make you say hot dog, yeah. So come on, wood chipping jack, call me wood cutting slim. Last girl I cut the wood for, you know she want me back again, yeah. Well, cross-cut soil, baby, drive me across your lawn. I cut the wood so easy, baby, you don't make me say I'm done. Well, cross cut soil, baby, drag me across your log one time. Well, cross cut soil, woman, drag me across that log, yeah. Cut you one so good, babe. Wanna make you say I'm done, yeah. Cut the wood in the morning, cut the wood at night. Last girl I cut the wood for, I made her feel alright, yeah. My cross cut so, babe, drag me across your love. I said I cut the wood so easy, babe. You know I gotta make you say I'm done, yeah. Cut the wood one time. We'll be right back.
so fast, could it work so slow, could it work so good, baby, you know you're gonna want some more. Send them across, go somewhere, baby, drive me across your door, yeah. I could it work so easy, baby, I'll make it say hot dog, now Scott Coulter, gotta cut that one more time, yeah. Open it up one time now. Drive me across your door. I cut you once so easy, babe. Wanna make you say hot dog, yeah. Said I'm gonna cross cut something. Drive me across your lawn. I'll cross cut something, babe. Drive me across your lawn. Cut you once so easy, babe. Wanna make you say, said I'm gonna cross cut something. Drive me across your lawn. I do what's so in the play. That I want to be sad. Keep going for Scott Coulter on the organ one more time.
Scott, that was, oh boy.
And that's Mike T on the tenor saxophone.
Mike T.
And Mike Gar on the trombone. Give it to him one time, the Eminem horns right there.
Oh boy.
Woo.
The crowd are going wild. Let me share some of these. Meg McIntyre is in the audience, and these guys are outstanding. She's here. She's commenting in both the comment section and in person. She loved it. Oh my gosh, so many people are happy. OMG, those keys, says Cheryl Koch. Luke is on point tonight, says Janet, Stowering Conrad. Everybody is just digging this. Robbie Fisher, this lead guitar playing is nasty, stanky goodness. Boy, do I agree with all that. All that. Guys, this has been such a wonderful night. I don't even want it to end. So I'll tell you what. Before we close, let me just maybe if we could quick go around ground the group. Anyone with mics here on this show? We're at the start of a school year here, and I'm wondering, can you each shout out a teacher or a mentor who was critical to your musical development? We call this the teacher feature.
Yeah, I mean, that's great. I think I'd be remiss if I didn't shout out, first and foremost, my dad, who came with me tonight. He's in the audience right here.
Hey, Dad.
So he was in there making noise when I was just learning how to walk, and some of it wore off, as you can see. So that's probably number one. And shout out to Todd Scheid and all the good guys, John St. At the California Drum Shop in Bethlehem. So shouts out to them. Shouts out to Dr. Chose and all the staff at the KU Jazz Department.
Yeah,
and just everybody that has helped me along the way. So who's next?
Excellent.
Yeah, I think I'll thank my dad, too. I remember going to see him play when I was really young.
Oh, musical dads. Gotta love them.
Yeah, yeah. He also...
no, I'm kidding. You do.
He engineered, mixed, and mastered all of our records, so we're gratefully indebted to him.
Oh, so. That name did sound familiar. That's fantastic.
Yeah, yeah. And him and Johnny DeFrancesco is a guitar player that I used to go watch play all the time. So,
any relation to Joey DeFrancesco?
Yeah, it's his brother, actually.
Well, there you go.
Yeah. So that was a huge influence. And I think Dr. Ron Grapsby at Kutztown was also a big influence.
Oh, shout out to Kutztown. Who else has a mic?
I got one here. Yeah, I mean, I'm from Colorado, so no one's going to know, well, the first one. But yeah, my in-person teacher, Art Landy, who I took with in high school, who's he's like Yoda when you take lessons with him. He's kind of a short guy, and he's staring up at you, and he's like one of those Zen teachers who just cuts at you, but he does it well.
Were there any particular pearls of wisdom you could share with us? any particular quotables?
Do I need to keep it clean?
Not at all.
All right. So, yeah, the first thing I ever played for him, I came in, I knew about him, I was nervous as hell. I sat down, I played, I thought it was a good rendition of whatever it was I was playing. I got to the end, I looked at him, he just stared at me for like 3 seconds, and he just told me, well, that was all bullshit, and told me to do it again. That was the first words ever out of his mouth. Yeah.
Wow.
It was good. It was good. But, yeah, that's my in-person, and the guy who I never met who is just my all-time idol is... Jimmy McGriff. Love McGriff.
Yeah. All right. Excellent.
I guess growing up, I'd say Kathy Moeller in elementary school, and then Carl Zeppelin in middle school, and then, you know, Ty and I studied under Dr. Chose at the university. He was, you know, definitely a good guy to work for, work under, so I'd say that's about it.
Excellent. Well, you sound great back there. Why do they call you Little Pete?
Young Pete. He just turned 13 about 3 days ago.
Oh my gosh.
No, Pete was a few years behind us at Kutztown, and while his talent is immense, we never let him forget that small fact. So it's just one of those things.
Thought he had that Benjamin Button disease.
He actually does. He's 45.
All right.
For me, I would say, I'll keep it simple. Chris McNew was my bass teacher in middle school, and kind of taught me my whole approach to thinking about music, playing music. So,
what does that mean? Your whole approach. What is the? Can you summarize it? That's a tall order.
That's
I
a
know.
Tough one. Just, you know, a very open. All about feeling, spirit, all that kind of stuff. He was a very soulful guy. So, you know.
Yeah.
That definitely is.
Do you find it's true that the bass player is usually like the most centered Zen person in a band?
I think you'd have to ask them.
I am totally getting that vibe from you, my friends.
I don't know.
He is in this one. Well, they're either that or they're nuts.
Yeah. We're crazy, right.
Yeah, the scale is tipped. So.
Well, yeah. Listen, guys, this has been an absolute lovely... Does anybody else have a mic that they want to share something with us?
Mike, you want
anybody else want to testify?
I just got to give a shout out to Greg Riley.
Greg Riley. Excellent, Greg Riley.
I'm going to take it.
Bone Man, sorry.
It's all good.
Yeah. That's right. Greg Riley. Shout out to Greg Riley, my college teacher. Fantastic dude.
Right on.
Definitely want to shout out to Paul Arbigas, college teacher there, Jared Antonacci. But, thinking about something, you guys were going around, thinking about a record that kind of was my teacher first. Definitely Otis Redding was in there. So us playing through that tonight has brought it back for me for sure. That, but Burt Bacharach.
All right.
Yeah, as the songwriter, as a writer myself.
Yeah.
Very good.
Inspiration there.
A lot of good shout-outs there, gents. We'll try to tag them in the comment section so they come out and hear you. Hear you sing their praises. Well, guys, thank you so much for being here. How are you gonna tuck us into bed tonight?
Thank you guys. Just thank you guys again so much. It's been a blast. Thank you to Dan and the whole crew here at Sellersville for having us. We can't wait to come back again when there's people who can stand up and party with us. Thank you to everybody watching at home in the comment section. Thank you to all you wonderful people who came here in person. We know it's only a few, but you're all safe. And sound and staying apart, and we appreciate you coming out and giving us claps and cheer.
Oh my!
And we hope to see you again real soon. GrooveMerchantsMusic.com is where you can go if you want to stay in touch
We got a brand new online store, and we're going to have a new 4-track live EP coming out. We got the single that Bob Dylan cover dropping hopefully real, real soon. Mm-hmm. So make sure you stay on the lookout for that. Follow us on Instagram and Facebook and all the fun stuff. And please, please stay in touch because we can't wait to be doing this again, you know, back to pretty much full time once all this shenanigans is behind us. So we hope everybody stays safe, you know, love one another, and don't forget to vote. And this last tune is a tune from our new record, The Throne, and it's called Stand and Deliver. Thank you guys again so much. We had a blast. We hope you all did too.
Thank you, Groove Merchants.
Been a long time coming, but you got to hear what I'm putting down. So we've been wasting time out there, and it's time for me to stand my ground. I gotta stand and deliver, no matter what lies in my way. Yeah, you know this ain't no smooth operation. Said you've been driving me insane, babe. We're beyond the point of miscommunication. And all you're causing me is pain. Hey, I gotta stand and deliver, no matter what lies in my way. On and on it goes, on and on it goes. Lead the sound, pray on the whole world. Time, you know, I'll do some rearranging. I'll get on nothing, turn me around. I got to stand and deliver, no matter what lies in my way. On and on it goes, keep the sound of some prayers on the phone. On and on. Up in them chains, and it appears that the clock has struck the hour. Now it's time for me to break, break, break away. And I got to stand and deliver, no matter what lies in my way. Thank you.
thank you all so very much. We are the Groove Pushers. We hope you had a blast. We'll see you soon. Good night.
Whoa, boy. Well, folks, that is our show. That was incredible. I hope you enjoyed it. A percentage of how much I enjoyed it. The crowd here is going bananas. That was wonderful. Please, on your way out, please make sure that you stop by the link tree. It should be appearing on your page momentarily. There are also links to be found in the event description and posted multiple times in the comments section by our lovely comment moderator, Alyson. Let's say hello and thank you to her.
Thank you, Alyson.
Let's say hello and thank you to Jeremy, who's been operating the cameras. Woo! Jeremy on the pans and tilts J-Dog. And zooms, crushing it as always. And of course, thank you to you in the comments section for your support and for your comments and for your energy. Thank you to the Groove Merchants. Good night, and we'll see you tomorrow, I hope.
Thank y'all so much. Thank you so much for coming out. Stay safe. We love you guys.
Holy smokes, guys. That was off the chart.
Dan, you're the man. Thank you so much.
Well done. Very well done. Thank you for